Okay, so next we'll be going with the stratified epithelium. Okay, so the stratified epithelium, as I told you, there are several layers of cells arranged. Okay, one below the other. So generally here the basements are absent. It is in the diagram they have given the basement, but in general. The basement has been absent. Okay, so and the main function of this is to protect the underlying structures. We all know that. So again, these are of two types, that is the stratified squamous epithelium and the transitional epithelium, right? So the stratified squamous epithelium, the first one is the stratified squamous epithelium, that is here. Okay, so here several layers of arrangements you can see. Okay, and we can see they are columnar, cuboidal, okay, squamous, everything has been present. There is no particular single layer of cells. Okay, all the cells are been mixed in this, but the main thing is the deepest layer which has been present contains the columnar cells. Okay, and when they goes on producing cells, when they go upwards, okay, we have seen this condition in the skin, right? Skin, what we have seen, the keratinized cells, okay, as they have keratinized cells, the new cells are been formed beneath, and the older ones comes upward, they are then they become dead and they are been removed and replaced by the new cells, right? The same thing this is taking place over here. Okay, so here the upper regions have the flat cells and the lower deepest regions have the columnar cells. In this we have seen again two types, that is the non-keratinized and keratinized. This non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelial tissue is been seen lining the wet regions of our body. Okay, wet regions where the organs or where these regions should always be in wet condition, like the conjunctiva of our eye. Okay, the conjunctiva of our eye, next the lining of the mouth, the pharynx, the esophagus, the vagina. Okay, all these things contains the non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, whereas keratinized can be seen in the dry places. Okay, like our hair, okay, skin, nails, all these things contains the keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. Next is the transitional. Okay, next is the transitional. So coming to the transitional, this is another type of what we say stratified stratified epithelial tissue, right? So here it is also composed of several pear shaped cells. Here we mainly have pear shaped cells. Okay, so and remaining all things are same, like they also have the columnar cells, cuboidal cells. Okay, pear shaped cells are been present on the top. Okay, and these are generally found as a lining of a urinary bladder, because as they have the pear shape, they allows the stretching. They are helpful for stretching. So generally these are found in the urinary bladder, because of when the urine capacity increases, the bladder stretches out. Okay, so for that reason it has been mainly helpful. So that is about our first part, that is the epithelial tissue. We have went through the simple type and stratified. In simple we have seen all these things, and in stratified also we have seen stratified squamous epithelium and transitional epithelium. In stratified also we have seen non-keratinized and keratinized. That is about the first one, and next we will go to the connective tissues. Okay, next part is our connective tissues. So the connective tissues, we can see most abundant tissues of the body. These are most amount which has been present inside our body, heavily present in our body. Okay, this is the most important tissue also. Next, these are widely separated from each other. Okay, like we have seen in the epithelial tissue, they are closely packed, right? But here these are loosely packed. Okay, they have wide spaces between them, and between them there are jelly like consistency or dense or rigid. Okay, like they may or may not be fibers present in the matrix. Like here you can see, right here. Okay, so they may or may not be fibers. The space between them is known as matrix. Okay, the space between two cells is known as the matrix. Okay, which may be of semi-solid, jelly-like consistency, or dense or rigid, depending upon the position and the function of the tissue. Right. So, major functions of the connective tissue. What are the major functions of the connective tissue? So, they are helpful for binding. Okay, and produce support. They're mainly helpful for binding and bring support and produce support, and they are also helpful for protection, transport, insulation. All these things are the remaining major functions. Okay, and connective tissues excluding blood, we also have blood over this. Yes, here you can see, right? This is one of the type of connective tissue. So apart from blood, it is found in all organs supporting the specialized tissues. Okay, so the different types of cells involved, like fibroblasts, fat cells, macrophages, leukocytes, mast cells, right? So the fibroblasts are large flat cells with irregular shapes. They produce collagen and elastic fibers and matrix of extracellular material. Mm-hmm. Okay, so they're associated with all these things. That's why I'm saying the basic what we say introduction for all these things. What are fibroblasts? These are flat cells with irregular shapes. They generally contain collagen and elastic fibers. Okay, and a matrix of extracellular material. What are fat cells? So fat cells are adipose tissues. Fat cells are adipose tissues. Okay, so these are adipose tissues, like they are singly present or they are in groups. Okay, groups of connective tissues, and these are generally found in the adipose tissue, mainly found in the adipose tissue, having various sizes and shapes. Okay, and next is the macrophages. Here you can see everything are present. I have first told the fibroblasts, right? Next one I have told regarding the adipose fat cells, right? Then now I am saying about the macrophages. Okay, the macrophages. So these are irregular shaped cells with granules in the cytoplasm. Okay, and some are fixed and some are attached to the fibers. Okay, they also have defense mechanism. They are involved in body's defense mechanism. Mainly these macrophages are helpful in producing defense mechanism in our body. Okay, and next, leukocytes. Okay, do we have any leukocytes anywhere? One second, let me see. Yes, okay, one second. Yes, so I was talking about the leukocytes, right? So the leukocytes generally have defense mechanism, right? So these are also seen with the associated with the connective tissues. They're generally seen during the defense mechanism. That is, if an infection is been introduced into the body, then they are mainly seen. So you can see them mainly in the lymph and the blood. Okay. So, and the last one is the mast cells. These are also like these are also having they also have the defense mechanism, and they are generally seen in under the loose connective tissues. Here we can see the loose areolar is a loose connective tissue. Okay, areolar is a loose connective tissue. There we can see the mast cells. Here you can see the mast cells, right? So all these things, they are generally, these mast cells can be seen in the liver, spleen, blood vessels. Okay, so all these things you can see the so these connective tissues are generally associated with all these things, that is the mast cells, macrophages, okay, next fibroblasts, next fat cells, leukocytes. Okay, all these things they are associated with. So